But yeah, people do this all the time. You got a beer in your hand, you're a drunkard. You understand? You got a cigarette in your hand, you don't know how to manage your money well. People got so many spending habits and things. People spend stuff on all types of things. Everybody just got different things they like. You understand? You know, the way I look at it like this, you take care of home, you take care of your business, I could care less what you do. You understand? I could care less what you do with your funds. It's not up to me to manage your household or manage your money. You understand? But I will say this, like I tell people a saying all the time, take care of home first. Do what you got to do. You know, make sure your bills paid. Make sure you got everything you got before you go get everything you want. You understand? That makes sense to me. You understand? It keeps you in line. It keeps you stable. He said, to whom much is given, much is required. He said, a man that can't manage his home well, you got to manage your home well. You understand? How can you expect to get more from God? You can't even manage your house. You can't keep your power on. You understand? How you going to keep the church's power on? You understand? It's not that I hate people. I tell people the truth. I tell people, and not a judgmental way, changes. You know, can I tell you a story of something that happened to me months ago? You know, it was a man, he kept coming to my house. And sometimes I got to just tell the story how it is. I got to tell the story how it is. There was a man coming to my house, and he kept coming. He asked for a little change, and I knew him. You understand? I give him what he asked for. You understand? Or I even give him some food or whatever. But he just kept coming. He kept coming. He has a car. He have this. He have that. He had all the means to take care of business. You understand? But I had to tell him one time. God put in my heart to tell him, hey, man, you got a car. You got this. You got to work. You can't expect people to keep taking care of you. You understand? You got to get out there. You know how many people who don't have cars? You know, you have a car. You have a vehicle and everything. And he was with an older woman at the time. And I was like, you can't expect her to take care of you your whole life. You got to work. Long story short, shortly after that, about 3 months later, the woman he was living with passed away. So now he has nobody to take care of him. And guess what? Here he shows up again. You understand? And I had to tell him the exact same thing. I helped him as usual. You understand? But I'm like, hey, I gave you some heads ups. Well, I think a lot of time that's God talking through me. I didn't know that was going to happen. I just told him what came to my mind. Whatever the Spirit led me to tell him. I'm like, you got to get out there and work. You got to provide for yourself. You understand? But most people be like, man, that's wrong for that. No, why is it wrong? Tell people the truth. Tell people what God tells you. You understand? So then they had that aha moment. Oh, whoa, this why this was said. I understand now. You understand? And some people will never understand. Some people, we live in a world that's full of users and abusers. People love to use people. Can I tell you something God told me years ago? When I got tired of people taking advantage of me and this and that, God was like, they ain't using you. I'm using you. And that opened my eyes up to a lot of things. Go through it. I got you. I'm using you. Man, being led in the Spirit is a whole nother ball game. You know, I may not be able to speak in tongues. I think when I first came to Christ a few years ago, 10 years ago, I was in a church and I felt it come a few times. And then it never fully manifested. You understand? And I do aim for that. I aim for spiritual gifts too. And you should too. You know, Paul said it like this. Covet to have spiritual gifts. Pray for it. Want it. You know what I'm saying? But a spiritual discernment is a spiritual gift. It's something we all need. You understand? So you won't be truly taken advantage of. You understand? Just think about it. Jesus helped all those people with the fish. Fed them all. And all they wanted to do was get free gifts and free food. And then when Jesus told them the truth of what for being a follower of Christ was all about, they was like, nah, I'm cool with that. You know what I'm saying? I don't want no part of that. If you ain't gonna keep giving me free stuff, I'm good. Let me follow off. Let me go take these words that you told me already and use them. If you really think about it, he said they were with us, but they're not with us. A lot of people left out following Christ, but I'm sure a lot of them kept those words, but now they misuse them. Really do the math, people. 1,000 went down to 11, but they knew the word of God, but they left out following him. The word has been spread so thin, and a lot of people have been shaken up this way or that way, You understand? Because a lot of followers that follow Christ, they follow for the wrong reason. Does it make sense? A lot of people that follow God, they follow for the wrong reason. It's not about self anymore. It's about God's kingdom and helping God's children. And you do that in so many ways. If you read Jesus' teachings, you'll see Jesus never really focused on funds. Jesus told Peter one day, he was like, we got to pay Caesar. Go fishing and pull that fish out. There should be a coin in his mouth. Take that coin. And he didn't even give him a bundle. He was like, take that coin and give it to Caesar. That's how much God care about money. You understand? He'll give it to you when you need it, to a fish. You understand? God is not a God of all about funds. When I think abundance and spiritual, I think bearing fruit. I think of bringing more people to Christ. I think in abundance like that. I'm not saying you can't be overflowed financially. But when I think abundance, a prosperity, a multiplying, I think in regards to God's kingdom, not in regards to myself. I think everybody want to have nice things, I'm sure. I got dream cars, a dream house, and all these type of things that's in my mind that I wouldn't mind having. But if God doesn't give it to me, so be it. If he do, great. But I'm still not going to push the issue on financial gain. It's not going to be something I'm going to push. Because I read my Bible, I read the New Testament, and it's never really about riches. It's more against it than for it. Have a blessed day.